The upside of renewable fuels is that they're sustainable, they reduce the environmental impact, and they can help potentially mitigate climate change. We particularly like algae as biomass or biofuel feedstock. Algae grow about 2 to 10 times faster than the best terrestrial crop plants. They often will store oils as a energy reserve product. And oils that come out of these algae, we've found, can be directly converted into fuels using pre-existing technologies.
So the laboratory is interested in this area because we have a mission around energy security, providing new technologies for energy for the nation. The big problem, the big challenge, is how to get that whole process to be economically and energetically efficient.
To make algal biofuels economically viable, there are two very important factors that we have to improve, and that's the biomass productivity per unit land area, or the yield, and the other very important factor that we need to improve is reducing the costs of harvesting the algae from the pond.
The laboratory is actually developing some nice technologies in a number of different areas, transforming algae so that it can produce more lipids, more biomass, overall better productivity under better conditions.
You've seen how we transfer the algae from the lab, from colonies on a petri dish to larger cultures. We bring them out here, adapt them to the outdoors and the sunshine. We begin to scale them up. Pretty soon we'll have algae at hundreds of acres, if not thousands of acres.
Another important concern is water. How much water are we going to use? And to address those issues, we're now focusing on developing heat-tolerant strains of algae that can be grown in ponds that are covered with plastic to reduce the evaporation. We've figured out how to engineer algae so they can use light more efficiently than normal algae do. We've seen up to a 2-fold increase in growth. We've also figured out how to engineer algae to make more oil. So at the time that we want to harvest the algae, we'll induce the expression of a gene that will cause all the algae to stick to each other, settle out of the pond, and then we pick them up. Maybe the last reason why we like algae is that we can recycle the nutrients that are in wastewaters.
Algae can do wastewater treatment better than conventional systems. So why not take an energy-intensive, expensive process and turn it into a energy-generating system where you're getting clean water and liquid fuels as your two products, and do that in a way that generates revenue rather than consumes revenue?